So if you're a fan of hip-hop music, you know our guest, photographer Brother Ernie Panicoli, has documented hip-hop culture since 1973. Along with being a renowned artist and photographer, Ernie Panicoli is also an author, an activist, a public speaker, and I just heard a former radio show host as well.
And I'm slowly becoming an elder.
Yes, absolutely.
At 66, I still got a long way to go, and I'm also trying to be a healer. And not mumbo-jumbo healer, but a person who prays and hopes that we can get people away from certain substances that are killing not only them. When a person is dying from that or hurt from that, it hurts his people, it hurts his family, it hurts his loved ones, and it hurts his community. So I don't preach. I just try to share that ancient vibe, and it works. And it's basically that we have to love ourselves more than others hate us, and that's the secret. It's no mumbo jumbo. We just have to learn to love ourselves, and when we love ourselves, we don't poison ourselves anymore.
Mm. Is that for that message of we have to love ourselves more than they hate us? Is that for all oppressed people,
all marginalized people? Oppressed people, because in order to marginalize or oppress someone, you have to at some level hate them. Mm. And you hate them because you don't know them. So we have to love ourselves more than others hate us. And that's a secret that has kept us here through all of the Holocaust, mental, spiritual, and the colonizations. Mm. My basic thing is decolonizing ourselves.
That loving ourselves, you talk about decolonization, the loving ourselves, what does that entail, you think?
Decolonization, you cannot decolonize the people externally. You have to do it internally, and not just in the community, but within your heart. I was in Jamaica, and I was a guest of some very nice elderly people, black people from Jamaica, really good people, and I sat down at the table, and on the wall, they had a big tapestry of the Queen and the royal family. And I could barely eat because I understood they were colonized. They didn't need chains, they were mentally colonized. So we have to decolonize ourselves. Khalid Muhammad said on a Public Enemy track, "Have you forgotten that once we were brought here, we were robbed of our name, robbed of our language, our religion, our God. We had forgotten our language, our religion, our God. And by the way, many of us have even lost our minds." Decolonization is an internal process, but before you can be decolonized, is you have to understand you are colonized. Like Sojourner Truth said, I believe, I freed hundreds of slaves, I could have freed thousands more if they knew they were slaves.
Mm. Yeah. You spoke about love, and I think before the show we talked about love in this room. You have some of your crew here with you. Do you want to let our listeners know who you have?
Sure, Rock. Who has a beautiful CD out, not beautiful, but powerful, called Smoke Signals. I have Jay Roby. I have Lily, who has healed me. I have Grizz on the Grind, who's a young filmmaker who's documenting indigenous people. And the link between us is that we all met here in the Toronto area, and they became like my children. They became my sons and daughters, and I became like a dad to them. And many of us, unfortunately, never had a father. I never had a father, so I became a father to my children and the extended. And I have to give a shout-out to Samita Bidaye, who helped connect us, and to all the young people with good hearts in Toronto.
Is that what brings you to Toronto this time? I know you've been here in the past, and we actually had Jay Roby, who's in the studio right now, on the show to talk about when you were going to be here the last time. For Igniting the Spirit. What are you in Toronto for this time? Is it for personal, or are you doing some talk?
I had to see my people.
That's what you're here for.
Yeah. Where I live in New Jersey, I walk down the street and people stare at me. People come up and want to touch my hair. Oh, I've never seen a native before. This is not Dancing with Wolves, you know. You're dancing with panthers and tigers and lions and bears now, but it's, you know, here we have more of us. There, unfortunately. And the ones we do have are so crossed over. We're beautiful. Let's be beautiful, you know.
Absolutely. I hear that. Everybody in this room you've described has a skill that they're bringing to this movement, to people, about love. I read that, or actually I watched a video where you said, Ernie, that you used your camera as a tool of liberation. Can you talk a bit about that statement and how you see us as people bringing our gifts to create that love?
Absolutely. First, there's a something that is confused by a lot of people. People think that hip-hop started in 1974 and that it was just a bunch of ragtag kids dancing and so on. No, it's an ancient spirit that's always been with us. That ancient spirit is literally, or was literally, a voice of the voiceless. It has since become colonized and used as a weapon against us to sell every kind of drug, alcohol, madness, literally making our young ladies look like prostitutes in the videos, make our young men look like fools with mouthfuls of gold teeth and worshiping brand name things and expensive cars and, you know, ludicrous $400 sneakers. So what was a voice of the voiceless has become a tool of the corporate world. And it's not some, you know, mystical conspiracy theory. No, what they want to do is not just enslave us mentally, but they want us to become ultimate consumers. So that when we hear this name or that name, we run out and buy the new improved one. In Harlem in New York, I saw kids sleeping for 4 days on the sidewalk like dogs, waiting to get the new Air whatevers. I'm not even going to mention their names. They sleep there so they can spend $150 and say, I was one of the first to get it. To me, that's mental colonization. That's harmful, because that's 4 days they could have been spending doing something else, and that's $150 or $300 or $400 that they can do, you know, buy food, clothing, shelter, please. So that's a form of colonization. And what I try to do is I try to help decolonize these young people by understanding that this is not a game. We're in this for survival. Mm-hmm. And for the first time in our history as a species, we are now at a crossroads technologically, where we're about to forget how to write. From the fifth grade up in Toronto, they no longer have pens and paper. They have iPads. So we're becoming technologically dependent, what John Trudell calls technologic. When you forget, or you no longer write, you no longer have that cursive, you no longer have that hand moving, you're losing part of your humanity and your ability to communicate and learn and absorb and educate.